Hello everybody, welcome back, Scratch for Fun here, and today we are doing some more Java, some more coding on our tower defense game. Now, today we are going to make this game full screen and start doing some painting. Now, essentially that is the easy part before we go into the towers and the, you know, the main road and enemies and stuff like that. So, let's open up our package here with our frame class first of all. Now, we want to make this full screen, so we'll have to delete the set size because we do not want to set a size. Basically, this will be full screen. Now, we got some other stuff here as well. We do not need to set the position to 0 as it will take up the entire screen, so we will delete that one as well. Now, let's jump in after the set default close operation and say this dot, and then we will say set extended state. Now, you got some extended states here. If this list does not pop up, just type in maximized both. Just type this in capital letters, and then we say this dot set undecorated and to true. So this basically means that we will not have this bar up here, so the name is not that important, though it will say, you know, down at your toolbar if you're running another game in front of it, or just looking at your desktop while that is running in the background and stuff like that. So extended state basically means that it takes up the entire width and goes essentially full screen. So let's do a little bit of run here. Now, let's hit run, and then, as you can see, I got a black screen here. This is now full screen. And then, to get out of this, you hit Alt Tab, and you can see some other stuff pop up, and then, yeah, you go into another window, basically. Now, as you can see, the game is... No, you can't see this, but the game is running in the background. Can I move this? The game is now running in the background here, as you can see the white screen behind me. So the game is running in the background, which is something that we not essentially want. Or, of course, it is okay running in the background because all of the other games are running in the background as well. So to get into it, just click on it to get out, Alt Tab, and there you are. Now, let's terminate this game. Let's hit this one right here and hit Terminate. Now, there is some stuff we want to get down. We want to have a exit button and stuff like that, which we'll go through probably next or next episode, something like that. But we are now going into the screen class because that is where the next stuff happens. This is essentially, for now at least, done, this frame class. Now, the screen class, we will be updating the entire game on forward. So, as I went through last time, we will basically have this public screen, go into thread.start, which will open up this public void run. Now, of course, we want to print out success. Let's do something like success, like so, and then frame created, something like that. It looks pretty cool. Now, what we want to do is we want, in our public void run method, we want a loop, which is basically the game loop. Now, the game loop is a loop that runs, you know, all the time while the game runs, and updates the screen, it updates, you know, everything, basically. So, let's do a while. Okay, we've done the while, and let's say while true. Now, this means it will run as long as the frame runs, or the game runs, basically. So if you jump out of the game, you know, the game will terminate, and this will not be run again. So in this while true, we want to do stuff. In this loop, everything is going to happen. You know, we're going to repaint. We're going to call a update method or a function, whatchamacallit, and this function will basically call the call all the updates and stuff like that, basically. So in this while loop, we want to say repaint. Now repaint is basically the one thing which will draw stuff on the screen all the time. So we now essentially draw stuff on the screen all the time, but that can be a little bit of a problem because this will, in a normal game, go around 2 million frames per second, and I have not seen any game in the world which runs at 2 million frames per second. Now, if we run this right now, it would run 2 million frames per second, which is you know, it might slow down the computer. I'm not sure how that works, but so what we're going to do is we're going to say, okay, we will force you to take a pause, okay? Now, 2 milliseconds is more than enough. So, let's run this with a try-catch thingy. And let's delete this auto-generated. We do not matter. If it can't sleep, if we get some sort of error, okay, just print this out. I don't care, you know. It doesn't matter if you skip some. I can actually just run without these, this one, and, you know, it will all run smooth. Now, we got our repaint and our sleep. Now, you might say, what does the repaint do? Now, this thing goes to a method called as much as public void paint component, there we go. And then this one requires a graphics, or it sends out a graphics which we will call G, and we will need to import the graphics. Let's import graphics quickly. There we go. Let's hide this one. And to check that we spell this correctly, do at override. I like to do that when the methods, when I don't call my methods myself, basically. So we now know that this is from the jpanel or runnable, probably jpanel, something like that. This method will be run. So, in our paint component, everything is going to happen. Now, how do we draw to the screen? How do we do stuff, paint stuff, images, stuff like that? Well, we got a graphics here, and we called it G, so we're going to do graphics, which is our G, and here we got loads of methods. You can set color, you can draw text, draw polygons, you can draw polylines, you can draw rectangles, strings, images, and, you know, everything. You can draw rectangles. Oh, beautiful. So, what we are actually going to do this episode as well, because I see we got some time, we are going to make the FPS, the frames per second counter. Now, this will not be, you know, viewable in the game itself, but as a debug mode, or we will be able to have a look at the debug mode and check some stats, basically. And that is, it's nice to have the FPS. So, let's do a private. Let's make a integer. Let's call this one FPS. Now, let's set the FPS equal to 0, which means that the frames per second will start at 0. Now, we want the, in our pin component, which is where everything gets drawn, we basically want to clear rectangle, okay? We want to clear the entire area every single time, because now how the computer works is it basically paints, you know, every single millisecond, I'm not sure, it paints onto the screen, okay? Now you can't paint layer on layer on layer on layer on layer on layer. You need to clear the last layer before you paint on top of it, or it will cause lots of lag in the end. So let's clear the rectangle from 0 to 0, and then we want the width. Now the width is essentially the width of this frame right here, so we actually need to save this frame. Let's do something like up here, frame. There we go, we saved our frame. Now we need to initialize it. This frame will be equal to this.frame is equal to frame. Frame, which basically means that this frame right here will be equal to this frame when we start our game. So we can now use this.frame, which is the frame which is basically this frame class right here, and we can do dot get width basically, which will give us the width of the screen. We can do the same for height, frame. Frame dot get height, and there we go. So it now clear from the left area up here to the bottom of the screen right here, which is not actually right here because I'm not recording full screen. But yeah, so we clear the rectangle, and what we want to do on top of that, we want to graphics.draw string. Want to draw a string, take this one with three arguments. We want to, first we need a string, which will be our FPS, and then we will need a X position, which will be 10, a Y position, which will be 10 again. Now, the thing is, 10 X position and 10 Y position is basically 0, 0 is on in the top left corner. Now 10x is basically 10 to the right, 10 pixels to the right, and y10 is 10 down. So we are now at 10x somewhere around here. I'm not sure what 10x is, but now as you see, we do get an error here. Change type of FPS to string, because this will need to be a string right here, but our integer will not be a string. So a trick you can do is to say plus and then a string, which now treats this entire thingy here as a string, and that's a cool trick basically. So this will now run, and it will draw the string, draw the integer FPS, which will be 0 at position 10 10. So if I hit start, we can see we are full screen, and there we go. I'm not sure if you actually can see this, but 0 0, hopefully you can see this, 0 0, no, it just says 0 up in the screen. Let's get out and let's terminate. Now we want this the FPS to update every single time basically. So in our public void run, we'll have to create a long. This long right here will be called something like last frame. Okay. Now this last frame will be equal to system.current time milliseconds. Now last frame essentially means last time we checked, or last time we updated our FPS. And then we also want a, what is it, is an integer or float, integer I believe it is, integer, and we will call this one frame since it is an integer. This will start off at 0. Now what we are going to do is we are going to say, okay, frames, you will add 1 to frames every single time this loop runs through, which basically means that frames will boost up super quickly. Now we will also make a if statement. If system.currentTime milliseconds minus 1000 is more or equal to last frame, basically. So this basically means that when the time reaches we reach 1 second, which is 1000 milliseconds, we will do something in here basically. So this is the current time right now in milliseconds, and you know, if we take the current time right now in milliseconds minus 1000 milliseconds, we will get the time for 1 second back basically. And if this 1 second back is more or equal to last frame, which basically means that we have passed 1 second, or is at 1 second exactly right now, we will do FPS is equal to frames, and now we updated our FPS with frames. Now we'll also need to set frames equal to 0 again. Telephone, sorry. So every single second we have counted up a amount of frames, and we set our frames per second to the amount of frames we managed to, you know, set at this very moment. Now, we will also need to set last frame equal to system.currentTime milliseconds. Now, I'm not sure what happens when you reach 12 p.m., I believe it is. Yes, 12 p.m., you know, and you get down to a.m. again. So what happens with the time at that moment? But if it goes down to zero, I'm not sure. If the last frame would never, ever, ever update. So if we run the game now, I'm not sure if you can see my frame, but if you run the game right now, you can see that the FPS updates in my is currently at 200, a little bit over 200 because I am recording. 250, something like that. Now, I can tell you something pretty cool, or I'm not sure if it is cool, but you know, in every single second, let's get the calculator up here. Calculator, in every single second, there's 1000 milliseconds. So, as you just probably knew from before, 1000 milliseconds in 1 second. Now, we sleep 2 milliseconds every single frame, basically. Which means that if we divide this by 2, you get a total amount of 500. Which means that, basically, you cannot get a FPS above 500. Above 500, that is impossible. Okay? So you can never get a FPS above 500, because if you get a FPS at exactly 500, it means that this takes 0 milliseconds to go through. Because we'd use 2 milliseconds, if this runs through 500 times, we are up to 1000, we've slept 1000 milliseconds, which is 1 second in total. And that means that if this gives you time, basically, you're able to do it. But, you know, it won't give you time by doing this. I'm pretty sure. So you'll never be able to get above 500, but if you change this one to 1, sleep in 1 millisecond, and run the game, you can see I'm now up in 370, 400. Yes, I'm a little bit above 400. And yes, so I'm a little bit above 400. Now, what is the maximum here? Well, the maximum is 1000. Because if you take 1000 and divide that by 1, you get 1000, basically. Or if you take 1000 and multiply by 1 multiplied by 1000, you get 1000. Pretty simple. Now, if you delete this, you will see something beautiful happen. Let's run the game. Now, since I'm recording, I won't get that much FPS, but I got 1.5 million frames per second. And it's bobbing around, you know, 1.6 million and stuff like that. So, you know, you can run without this, but it's not necessary having 1 million frames per second. Just telling you that. So, we've gone through how to draw strings, how to draw FPS and stuff like that. You can just play a little bit around with this. I'm trying to, you know, keep this open for changes in the future, so that you yourself can, you know, do stuff how you like to do stuff, basically. If I choose to have my money down in the corner below, you know, or down in the left corner, you know, you would like it to have it up in the left corner, you know, you can do that as well. I'm basically trying to teach you how to do stuff so you can change it later. Now, I believe that was everything. This episode we didn't go through that much, but we got full screen and we got our FPS counter up and running. So, That is pretty sweet, I believe it myself, sorry. yes. Thanks so much for watching, everybody. I am Scratch Fun. Remember to subscribe below and have a nice day on. Goodbye.